Hello, good morning. I hope you guys are keeping safe. Safety is very important and that is concerned to us. Well, today we will be doing a nice classes which is already in your circumference, and that is called the Italian pastas. What we are doing it, we would be making three kinds of pastas for your things. One, we will be doing a fettuccine which is made homemade, which I will show you how to do that. We will be making spaghetti, which will be carbonara, and we will be doing penne al olio. So, to do all these things, this is a couple of things which we will be doing it. As you know me, Chef Clement here. Well, before we start with the glaze, as I showed you already the menu, you remember I always say the three things. First, you need to plan what you want to do. Second, you need to organize. And the third, you have to execute. The execute part is something that comes the kitchen cooking technique. But as I said, planning. For this planning, we have set up a beautiful line for you with the help of the team, which we will work together to do that, which we have planned the menu for you. The plan of the menu is we are making three pastas, one with fettuccine, one with spaghetti, and one with penne. So to do this one, we have planned everything and now we have organized. To do this one, I want to take it to you of different ingredients what we are going to use. So I'm going to introduce to you what the ingredients we are using to make three kinds of pasta, right? Obviously, when you're making an Italian food, you have to have two things very important. One, they don't do cooking with normal oil. They always use your olive oil. So it's your olive oil. And the second one is your Parmesan cheese. The Parmesan cheese, which we have it here for you to have. We have made some couple of mise en place for your references. We have taken some nice parsley, curled parsley for garnishing, some basil for garnishing, some kepa berries for garnishing, grated Parmesan cheese, some oregano, some chopped parsley, black olives, dried red chilies, some nice cherry tomatoes, your chopped onions, your cracked peppers, some cream, garlic, and obviously salt. As we said that we would be making a spaghetti, we have taken the spaghetti which I have boiled it for you. Please remember, to boiling this process of spaghetti, you need to have a nice water boiling with a lot of salt and a little bit of olive oil. It takes minimum about 9 minutes to cook the spaghetti, and in the same vice versa, this penne. It takes minimum of 9 minutes on depend of if you, how you are putting in the boiling water to boil it for you. I have boiled it for you. Remember that this penne, it cannot has to be overcooked. This underdone penne is called al dente. To understand this al dente, you will see a white mark here which says that it has to be al dente. You cannot have to have pasta fully boiled, because Italian, they don't like fully boiled penne. It has to have a little bit of andante that give you the crunch of having the food. We have nice basil to make pesto. I will show you how to make the pesto. We have some nice pork bacon. You can use it or you can omit it. It totally depends on how you want to do that. We have some pine nuts for making pesto. So, the first thing what we will make today is how to make pesto. As to make the pesto, we have a mixing machine here which we will put it all together to make a nice pesto. To make a nice pesto, you need to have a couple of basil, you need to have garlic, you need to have a little of Parmesan cheese, a you have to have pine nuts. And then we will use olive oil. Lot of olive oil actually. Once you have both the things, seasoning we will do it later. You just need to help our mixing machine. You just have to plug it in, close it properly, and then switch it off. See how it looks. If you need to add a little bit of blue basil to give you color, you can add a little bit of blue basil to give you color. There's no harm to put a little bit of basil more that will give you green in color. You see, the color has changed. It can give you more green in color, and I want it a little bit more in green color. So as I said, no harm of putting more basil. It depends on how you want to do that. Pesto, the texture and the pesto, you see how beautiful it is with a nice green in color. We already made the pesto, we will keep it here. Your pesto is ready, which we will use for the fettuccine to make the pesto. Once your pesto is ready, you see the color and the texture is like nice. It's nice, give you nice aromatic of the pesto, of the fresh basil. Normally they use sweet basil leaves to make a pesto. So the ingredient for pesto is basil, sweet basil, garlic, pine nuts, parmesan cheese and olive oil. You have to remember the five fingers. Five ingredients to make pesto, I repeat, is sweet basil, your parmesan cheese, your olive oil, your garlic, and your pine nuts. So your pesto is ready. Pesto, P-E-S-T-O, it has five words, and you have to use five different ingredients to make a pesto. And I think it is very simple. So we keep it as a part of the mise en place for you to grill it up. You would be requiring flour. Normally they use gluten flours, zero gluten flours, and you need a free-range eggs. The recipe for this is very simple: 600 grams of flour, and you need only 6 eggs to make a dough. But we would be using 300 grams of flour, and for that, if you cut down the recipe, it costs only 3 eggs. So we would be making a little bit of flour to it. You have to make a hole inside like a well, right? You have to take 3 eggs, 300 grams of flour and 3 eggs. So we will crack the egg and we will put it in this. Then simple, with the help of your tip of your fingers, you just have to mix it nicely. Once you mix it well, you need to put some little bit of salt. And you mix it well. For that, to make a pasta thing, you need to have a pasta machine, which is here. We will put it all to the pasta machine to make this dough. So once you mix it well, you see, you need to understand, to make a good dough, you need to give a rest the dough for nearly about half an hour inside the refrigerator. The reason why, once you keep it a rest, it gives you the smooth feeling and you can actually make a nice dough out of this, and it doesn't give you the lump. Make this dough. So when you're making this dough, you see that already it has given you the structures and getting up how to make the dough. You see, once you do this one, you will have beautiful dough which is coming out. As I said to you, that to make the dough is very optional, that you have to keep it for nearly about half an hour, nicely wrap it in a clean film. Cover it. And it goes inside the refrigerator for half an hour. That is advisable to get it, to get a nice. So we will be putting this inside the fridge. So we have taken the dough out from the fridge. Now we will make a nice pasta to make it from there. So to do this, we need to have, you take this, I'll take half the dough of it, okay? We need to adjust this. You have to go this one nearly about 5-6 times to make this pasta dough. You have to make it very fine, very nice. You have to pass through that machine for nearly about 5-6 times. Once you do this one, what happened? It gives you a fine, smooth texture without any kind of lump. So you see, we are passing through a nice, with a rolling machine, which is called a rolling pin machine, where we pass it around with this. Interesting thing, if you see, it is in white in color, but if you want to give little bit of different color, you can use actually wild spinach. You can use beetroot, you can use parsley if you want, but it's totally depend. This is actually a simple white dough, but you can give different color by adding whatever you feel to have it. You can have a blanch spinach, where you have to blanch the spinach, make a puree out of it. When you are making the dough, use that spinach to get it. It will give you a green dough. But if you want to make it red, you can make the same process. Beetroot, boil the beetroot, make the puree out of it, mix it together, it gives you red in color. If you want to make it tomato, you can make it. You have to make it sun-dried tomatoes. And then what happens? You have to mix it all in the gift to give a different color of how you want to cook it. So I'm passing through that machine about 5-6 times to give you a different texture. Right? Requiring the help of a gentleman who would be helping me to make this thing, because if you see, after you rolling the dough, you will have this kind of sheet. It totally depends that how big you want it to do that. And if you try to put it in that machine, this is the structure of called fettuccine. This one is called the spaghetti. If it little bit thick, if you see the structure little bit thick, it becomes tagliatelle, which is like a ribbon consistency. But now we are making fettuccine, so this is where the fettuccine, it is like little bit diameter of half, not even half a centimeter, it's a little bit lesser than that, which we will cut it off and we will show it to you. So to get to this dough, you see how nicely the dough came out with the sheet of what we have. Now we don't want it so long like a noodles. What we will do, we will cut it into small pieces, preferably this size. See the size? And then we have this. So, once we have this one, with the help of this gentleman, we will roll it from this thing. For this to roll this thing, you have to put it inside, and then automatically it goes inside. See this?
Yep.
We'll make a couple of those. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you. So see, you have nice fettuccine. To dust it, you just have to take a little bit of flour, dust it, so the moist and doesn't get stick together. So this is very important that you dust it and then you roll it like this, so it doesn't stick together. This is very important, otherwise you see, when the moist of this thing can stuck and your dough can get stuck. So you see, this fettuccine, it gives you a little bit of things which it doesn't stick together. This is the key of making a homemade fettuccine. We have put some boiling water for you. We will blanch it and we will show you how to cook. As I said when I started my class, it says that it takes about 9 minutes to cook a packet one, but when you are doing a homemade, it takes little time to do that, and this is very, very important. So for this, you have your water boiling. You need just to take a little bit of salt, season it well, little bit touch of olive oil. Right? With the help of a strainer, you put it inside. The water is boiling hot. You have to take a little bit of this. It doesn't take too much time to cook. If it takes 9 minutes for this pasta to get cooked, this takes about 2 to 3 minutes to get it cooked. So now we will do the first dish. Now to make the dish, you have all the ingredients what we have in here, which is fettuccine. Which you have pesto, we have salt, garlic, onion, little bit of basil leaf, cherry tomatoes, we use the pepper mill for the cracked peppers and olive oil. And most importantly, we may missed it, is the grated parmesan cheese, which we would be using to finish it off. So to get it off, these are the ingredients. We have to fill the pan is hot. We need to make a little bit of olive oil in it. Once you put olive oil, a lot of people make a mistake that they put garlic first, but garlic doesn't take time. It is a matter of onion which has to go first. So we'll put some onion to it. We have to sweat the onions so it doesn't get over colored. Once it is sweat, you see we are cooking. You feel that the onion is getting cooked. This is the technique which we would get. Once the onion gets a little bit of salt, you have to put your garlic. Italian likes too much garlic. So, we put some garlic. We saute this garlic very well. Okay. Optional is, if you want to put a little bit of white wine, you can do that. But I'm not putting white wine. I am sauteing with onion and garlic. Right? And then, what we will do, as this is a fresh pasta, we don't need to put this one in a hot water because it's already hot. So what we will do, we will put it, you see, all the pastas together. You see, this is homemade fettuccine, which we will make it with alla pesto. Remember that pesto will lose its color if you put it now. Pesto is something that you give it in the last moment. That is the key of getting out of these things. So as I said, that now we will be seasoning it with a little bit of cracked peppers. Correct? We will be seasoning it with a little bit of salt. In pesto, I have not put salt. Here I am putting salt. And then we will be putting a little bit of Parmesan cheese. Mix it well. I have not used the pesto. As I said, I would be using the pesto in the last moment. If you put it now, the color might change because the pesto will get cooked. We want to give you the frequency of things. You see that pasta has been cooked. You switch it off. So you see? Mix it well. Your fettuccine alla pesto is ready. Now we will be doing this plating. Cherry tomatoes. So what I do, I'll cut the cherry tomatoes into half. Just for the garnish. Put it down here. You take these plates. We will plate now. So the key is, you just have to twist it in a very nice way, because your eye eat first, then your stomach. So we will give you the volume of how we can do that. So you see this. Remember the cherry tomatoes what we have put. You can put a garnish like this. Some nice basil leaf.
dash of oil what we have. You can put it like this. Some Parmesan cheese. And then a nice prick of basil for the garnish.
It's called this spaghetti carbonara. To do this carbonara, the main ingredient for the carbonara, as I said, you would be requiring spaghetti, you would be requiring onion, you would be requiring a liaison, which is made with cream, egg yolk, Parmesan cheese. We cooked it in a double boiler. We will be using a pork bacon. Right? And for the garnishing, we will be using a Parmesan basket, which I'm going to make, which I already made it for you. And then we will be doing a crispy bacon to do the garnishing. So to do this, I would be requiring black peppers, olive oil, and definitely some grated Parmesan cheese. So these are the ingredients which we are going to make it. And to make it, we will be requiring this to chop it to get it up to the stage. So I would be requiring bacon, which is the main ingredient for pork carbonara. This is bacon is made with pork. It's pork carbonara. And then what we will do, we will make a strip of pork bacon. As I said, we are not going to use garlic because bacon itself has a nice flavors. If you put garlic, it will just bring it on hot. So for this, we will definitely requiring a pan. Make the pan hot. Once the pan gets hot, we would be putting this bacon inside this oven. It's getting cooked. I want bacon to be a little bit crispy. Once it gets crisp, we take it out. This one we will use for the garnish for your spaghetti carbonara. And we have a little bit of olive oil. Remember that we have bacon. We put some bacon inside. We want the flavors of the bacon to come out. We cook it. And in the meantime, you have to have your water to be hot because we want to make your spaghetti to be hot. So we have some boiling water which we have put a little bit of oil in it. We will put it with the help of the strainer. We put it inside so it gets hot. Once the pork bacon is a little bit of cooked, it is wet. We will be putting this onion. Sweat it well. Once the thing getting cooked, the water is hot. You take how much portion you need it to do to make it. The water, cook it well. Once your pasta is hot, you take it,
strain it off, and straight away in the mixer. You see? You season it with a little bit of cracked pepper. Be careful with the salt, because cooked bacon itself has a little bit of salt in it. So you have to be very careful when you are putting the salt. So add a little bit of salt, because as I said, cooked bacon itself has a salt. So once it gets cooked, a little bit of it. What you do, you put your yellow, which is made with cream, egg yolk, parmesan cheese. You add it in the mixture of how much you need. And then you mix it well for your spaghetti carbonara. You see this? Don't cook it too much. Switch it off. You have some nice chopped parsley. You can put some parsley for your garnish. Okay, and then switch it off. So your spaghetti carbonara is ready. You can put a little bit of more yellow if you want to make it a little bit of juiciness of how you like to do this, right? So these are the main ingredients of making it up. The parmesan basket, I took it out from the oven. We put it like this. As I said, that you have to elevate the food to the next level. So your carbonara food is ready, your basket is ready, which I made it and showed it to you. And this one, we will present it, this thing. As I said again, your eye eat first, then your stomach. So now we are trying to elevate the whole food to a different tangent. You do this thing, we are just doing the plating now, where you have your carbonara ready. So what you do, you twist it well, the leftover bacon on the top. Taken, you take a good piece so the crisp come down here, and then either so your spaghetti carbonara ready. As I said, your eye is first, then your stomach. Spaghetti carbonara, we give it to a different angle to give it presentation. So this is what it is. And get it out. So the main ingredients, what we have used it, parmesan cheese, bacon. This one is the main ingredients, olive oil. So the another interesting dish what we would be making is for you is penne arrivi, or in other words they can call it AOP, which is in a very short form to make it stand, but both of them stand same. So actually the name is penne arrivi. We can make it
with either with spaghetti, we can make it with fettuccine, you can make it with tagliatelle, you can make it with anything, with ravioli also. This all depends on what pasta you are using. To make this dish, we have certain things which we are going to use. We would be making it with penne, which we have cooked it. As I remember what we said, that penne has to be untante, because we have to do a second cooking when you are cooking it for this thing. This is the first cooking to keep it untante, and the second cooking when we are cooking it up, we put it to make it hot. So for this, we would be requiring a little bit of penne. We would be requiring onions. We would be requiring a little bit of olives, which we will cut it for you. We will make it how you wanted to do this. It in all in one together for your better understanding. We would be requiring dry chili flakes, which we are clipping it down here. We would be requiring a little bit of cherry tomatoes, which we will cut it into half. You, we would be requiring chopped parsley, we would be requiring caper berries, which we for the garnish, but you can use small caper berries. We would be using definitely Parmesan cheese, we would be using salt, we would be using garlic, we would be using your cracked peppers. And if required, we will be garnishing it with this basil. So, all the ingredients is ready. We will be making a nice GOP, which is a little bit of spicy with a lot of flavors and things. We can enhance the flavors also with some oregano. This is very strong flavors to give you nice flavors from the oregano. If you have seen in the other cooking, I have not used oregano, because oregano is one of the major spice to enhance the flavor. So this dish requires all these ingredients to make it more flavorful. So we would be cooking it now for your references to make it understand. So your pan is getting hot. What you need to do, you just have to put a little bit of olive oil. When you're putting this olive oil, first, as I said, that you need to put onion first. So we are putting this onion. Get a little bit of saute. We would be putting a little bit of garlic. This garlic will enhance the flavors, and this dish needs something to get it up. So you have your garlic ready. Once your water is getting hot, you have to put down your penne for your second cooking, which I'm going to do it now. You remember, and whatever we have done it, black olive, tomato and caper berries, we shot it in inside to give you a mix. We'll take some basil, put some leaf inside of the basil, so all these flavors enhance to this thing. Some chili, dry chili. We mix it well. You've seen it that I have not seasoned it with any kind of salt or something. Once you put the penne, you will come to know that how much salt you have put. So your penne is getting hot, is getting hot, is getting cooked. So what you do, you put it inside. Once you put it inside, you just give a toss. You just put a little bit of salt, some cracked peppers, get it up, some parmesan cheese, and some chopped parsley. You just give a toss. Your penne is simple, right? It's all mixed together, tossed it well. It all depends on how spices you want it, or how you can omit the chili spice. But if you like spicy, why not? Add more. It's totally your preferences of yours of how you want to do that. Your thing is right. Now is the time for plating. Italian food is very simple. You enjoy the pasta with fresh ingredients. Everything is being fresh. Doesn't take time. It's just a matter of enhancing the flavors and getting out of the things. Everything. But if you want to still enhance the flavors, you can add a little bit of oregano. As I said, this gives you the aromatic of what the pasta looks like. So now we will be doing the plating. As I said, that we need to give a garnish of each and everything. We put it up all together here. Garnish with some pepper berries, not much, right? Things, we want to take a parmesan flakes. To do the parmesan flakes, you just need to get it up to this next, nice. But once you get the flakes here, you just have to take it a nicely put garnish. Some nice basil leaf, if required add some parmesan cheese,
IIHM. For a great hospitality career, call 983105000.